Thank you. वन की परिक्रमा हुई और वहां से ठाकुर मंडल होते थे हम लोग यहाँ पर आए
So one day, he posed the question to Venkata Bhatta, and he said, "You know that it is said that your worshipable deity, Lakshmi Devi, that she wanted to engage in the pastime of entering the Rasa tent so that she could come and enjoy this Leela with Lord Krishna. So please tell me, why is it that she wanted to enjoy this Rasa tent?" So then Venkata Bhatta, he answered, he said, "No, this is natural for her because she sees that her Lord, Lord Narayan, he is not different than Lord Krishna. But this form of Lord Krishna, as a cowherd boy, dancing in Vrindavan with gopis, is very, very attractive, full of a very sportive nature. So there is no fault in her. Although she is the topmost of all Chaitanya ladies, Lakshmi Devi, she is always resting on the chest of Lord Narayan, her husband. She is completely dedicated and devoted to him. So we cannot consider it her fault that she wanted to associate with Lord Krishna, because she knows that Lord Krishna is not different than her worshipable Lord and husband, Lord Narayan." So in this way, Venkata Bhatta, he explained that there's no difference between Lord Krishna and Lord Narayan, but the only difference is in terms of rasa, rasa vichar. And Lord Krishna, he has this specific nature. So then, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said, "Yes, this is all true. But there's another point here. And what is that? We understand that actually, even though Lakshmi Devi wanted this, and she attempted to perform severe austerity, but yet she was not able to attain this." And then he quoted a verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto, in which the wives of the Kali servants, they were glorifying Shri Krishna and praying to him. And they said, "Kanagrava Bhavo, in the name of this Mahi, Tamantari Indus Parashan Vikara, Yasvansa Yasriya Ramanasana Tapo, Vihaya Kara, Suchidam Pitta Brahma." So Lakshmi Devi heard his tone that, this dust of the lotus feet of Lord Krishna that was placed upon the head of the servant Kaliya is something that is so difficult to attain. We don't know how it is possible that this servant was able to attain the dust of the lotus feet of Lord Krishna upon his head. Because even Lakshmi Devi, who performed for a very long time severe austerities and penances, she was not able to have to attain this kind of benediction. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went on to explain that actually, although she tried to attain this position of entering into the Rasa tent and trying to become like the gopis, in fact, we know that she went there to Vrindavan, and there in Vrindavan, performing her austerities, she was finally attracted to Lord Krishna, and that she was told that, "Yes, you can have this opportunity to enter into my Rasa tent, but you will have to accept a few different criteria in order to enter into this Rasa tent." "What is that?" "Oh, first of all, you will have to become a gopi. You will have to perform the activities of a gopi, living in the village, milking the cows, churning yogurt, making cow dung patties, and so forth." And this she could do. But when she was told that she will also have to accept Krishna as her husband and become the partner lover of Krishna in this secret way, Parakivara, and to her this was impossible. She could not accept this. Yes, and to marry a gopa. Because all the gopis in Vrindavan, they have this mood that they are sneaking away from their husbands to associate with Krishna. So before they have this mood, they have to have this relationship with the boy. So Lakshmi Devi, she was not able to accept this because her whole mood is that of the wife of Lord Narayan and a Brahmani mood. So for her, it is impossible to adopt this move of the gopis as Maharshi Yoga. So, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he explained that the only way that anyone can enter into this relationship with Krishna is to accept the move, the path of the Prince Bhakti. And especially if someone wants to enter into the Rakatan and wants to associate with Krishna in the way of the gopis, then the only way that you can do this is to accept the anugrahya, following in the very moves of the Prince Gopi. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he wants us to explain that actually there is no difference between Lord Narayana and Lord Krishna. But this is by Siddhanta. By the position of Siddhanta Vichara, understanding Tattva, there is no difference because Sri Krishna, Lord Narayana, they are multiple personalities. Just like the moon in the sky, we see it at different phases of the moon's appearance during the month. Sometimes the moon is full. Sometimes the moon is a quarter moon. Sometimes one the eighth moon. Sometimes new moon, no moon. So all these different phases of the moon, they appear to us to be different. But actually it is the same exact object, it is only the moon. So in the same way, Sri Krishna, he manifests unlimited form to take unlimited varieties of rasa and to reciprocate with all his eternal devotion in many different ways. But actually they are all one, they are all identical. But the superiority of Krishna, this is the unique point. As Chaitanya Mahaprabhu began to explain by Rasa-vichara, Sri Krishna, he has four qualities which no other form of his has, not Lord Narayana or any other of his expansions or incarnations, have these four qualities. And they are called his four madhuris. They are his rupa madhuris. His very exquisitely beautiful, sweet form. There is his jiva madhuri, the pastimes that he performs, like his beautiful childhood pastimes that we are hearing about every day in Damodar Leela. And his pastimes all in Vrindavan, as he grows through the different ages, as he associates with all of his devotees in such sweet reciprocation, the Leela madhuri. Then there is Guna madhuri, all the qualities that Krishna exhibits, and his different varieties of personalities, like Dhirubhata, Dhirudhata, Dhirulakita, and Dhiruprasad. Four different types of personalities Krishna exhibits. So, these qualities of Krishna and his Vedamadhuri, nowhere does Krishna play flute like he does in Vrindavan and attracts the hearts of all the rich bodies and brings all the gopis to Bhakti Bhakti and performs Rasa-lila with them. So these four qualities of Krishna, his four madhuris, they show that Krishna is superior. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu quoted the verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna's two Bhagavan's life. When all the incarnations are considered, all the different expansions of Krishna are considered as his umshas, his parts, and his phalas, the extensions of his parts. But Krishna himself is called Bhagavan Swayam, because he is the very source of all of them. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also quotes the verse. Sayam Shriyoga Unikanta Nate Prasada, Swayoshika Shalina Ganta Nujam Sutroya, Rasok Sade Utadakta Vajita Kanta, Labha Shishamya Udagata Rajasutra Rika. This verse is from Sankhya Srimad Bhagavatam, and it is discussing how the goddess of fortune could never attain this benefit that the Braja Gopis attained. How, in the rising of the dance, Krishna put his two beautiful golden arms around their necks. Even the goddess of fortune herself, and what to speak of even the demigoddesses in the heavenly planet, whose bodies are fragrant like lotus flowers, none of them could attain such favor as these Braja Gopis have attained. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he expressed the superiority of the position of the Braja Gopis. And based on the Bhatta, he accepted from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu his superior position, and then he told that it is not possible for me to actually comprehend all of deep, deep, deep truth, deep, deep reality. But you have a part of your mercy within my heart. And then at that point, they got the Buddha fell into the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and surrendered to him, and they became worshippers of Sri Krishna, Nanda of Sri Krishna, from Brother Vrindavan, along with his whole family members. So this pastime that is performed of Lakshmi Devi, going there to Vrindavan, informs us that actually there is no superior position than the worship of Sri Krishna in the womb of the Brajic Gopis, right here in Raja Vrindavan. And this is our final goal of attainment, to worship Sri Krishna and in the association of his eternal associate and Sri Sri Radha Krishna in the Raja Vrindavan.
सभी गोपियों में पार्थिव भाव है। गोपी के घर में उसके घर से जन्म होना, गोपाल से विवाह होना पार्थिव भाव होना। अब तक जो साधन सीखा है वो गोपियों के साथ में उनकी सेवा करके परिपक्व होंगी, और जो परिपक्व नहीं है उनको रोक दिया जाए। इसलिए पार्थिव भाव का होना जरूर। पार्थिव भाव है गोपियों का अन्य पत्नियों के साथ में विवाह और कृष्ण के प्रति प्रीति, इसको कहते हैं पार्थिव भाव। जब तक नहीं होगा कोई भी राग मैं कृष्ण के साथ में संबंधित नहीं होगा। इससे लक्ष्मी जी नहीं हो सकती, अन्य गोपों से विवाह करने के लिए राजी नहीं हुई। कृष्ण से शादी कर सकती है क्योंकि कृष्ण और नारायण जी की तपस्या है, तो और लोग इससे आज भी तपस्या कर रहे हैं, किंतु राज से सम्मिलित नहीं हुई। आज हम लोग इसके बाद में भारू मरुमंडल में गए, उसकी कथा कुछ हुई हुआ पन्नाला जी कुछ बोलिए तो मरुमंडल से संबंध में।
जीव बसे आपके निकट खूब प्रस्थान पर आगे और जीव बसे
उन्नीस साल के निकट एज ए अध्यशाली जी जिस पुत्र बाल के शिक्षारू के रूप में ही
हाथ करने लगे सब मंत्री
राजा जी मंत्री
आपकी जो से आप कुछ बन गया और फिर प्रभाव ने कैसे गोमराज के चरण चरण में रुक करना दी और जिस को दृष्टि जब राम के साथ राम के दिवस को रखा करके पूरे समय के राम के साथ जिला राम के चरण और उसके इंद्र ने पकड़ी और उसमें उसके द्वारा ही प्रसन्न हो सके और उसके द्वारा उसे दुराचार और एक उसी का दान कर दिया था जिसे आज के आज तक भी उसी संप्रदाय में ये दिन के बीच में एक दिन जाने दिन के रूप में उन्हें शरण कर दिया और इसी प्रकार कृष्णदास ने आदमी के आनंद प्रदान किए इसलिए कि मनुष्य इंसान मनुष्य भी नाम रख दिया श्यामानंद तो उस समय घर में उसके नाम प्रचलित हुए श्यामानंद इसी प्रकार यह धर्म में भी विशेष होता है राधा जी की कृपा प्राप्ति करने के लिए हमको धन देना जब तक हम विदा के धन नहीं दे कि वो स्पर्श धन देना ही है हम विदय की दर्ज में कैसे धन देना है
Thank you.
as one of my team told about Kalimanda. Shamananda.
So Sri Gurudev was talking about Bayama.
They last week before the class they were injured in Ramadilla and she was unsuccessful.
Why?
We have heard that when Krishna blew his flute, only the gopis ran into injured in Ramadilla. Therefore, to become a gopi is complete necessity. Otherwise, no one can enter. Especially all the gopis, they serve Krishna in Bhaktiya Bhava. They were not aware of the Bhaktiya Bhava. One must take birth in the family of gopis, and one must marry Gopa, otherwise, where's the question of Bhaktiya Bhava? What to think of any other gopis, even the sons of the gopis who had not achieved complete maturity? When Krishna blew his flute and called the gopis, they could not enter. Somehow or other, they were checked. But the seventh in the gopis, by performing the seva and by associating with the eternally perfected gopis, then they were mature, they could enter the Ramadilla, otherwise not. Devas and Lakshmi could not agree to these conditions. So, pretty much, one more I was discussing about Sri Jalamanda. There, after Sri performing Narasana Srinivasa Shamananda, they are called Prabhu Shraya, the three Prabhu. Sri Narasana Swami has taken Nisha from Sri Gopinath Swami. Sri Shamananda has taken Nisha from Sri Virajana, and Sri Srinivasa Shraya has taken Nisha from Sri Gopabhata. But all three were taking shiksha from Sri Jiva Goswami here in Vrindavan. Therefore, if you want to understand what is Diksha and Shiksha Guru, you will have to go to Jesus and the Charitamrita. The Shiksha Guru is considered to be Krishna.